Hare Krishna. I warmly welcome all of you for the special session on behalf of ISKCON Chennai. As we had already told you, now we will have the good fortune of meeting one of the senior most gurus and sannyasis of the International Society for Krishna Consciousness. He was one of the earliest disciples of Srila Prabhupada, His Holiness Bhanuswami Maharaj. He is a special guide who is the great fortune of ISKCON Chennai, who is constantly available to guide the temple and the devotees. Whenever he is in Chennai, he regularly gives Bhagavatam classes for the benefit of visitors and residents. So he is now going to address all of you. I am just going to give you a brief introduction about him. So His Holiness Bhanuswami Maharaj was born to Japanese parents in Canada in 1948. So his parentage is Japanese, and he did his BA in Oriental Fine Arts in history, Oriental history, in British Columbia. At the age of 20, he got connected with the International Society for Krishna Consciousness by seeing the devotees who were visiting Canada, ISKCON devotees, and he became very much attracted to ISKCON. And he joined the following year in ISKCON as a full-time devotee. And he was traveling with ISKCON parties everywhere. And Srila Prabhupada appreciated him very much for his great knowledge of Sanskrit. Within 1 year, he could pronounce Sanskrit with such diction that Srila Prabhupada greatly admired him. And then he was translating Srila Prabhupada's books from English to Japanese. That was his early service in literature. But at the same time, he was mastering Sanskrit and Bengali. In 1984, he took sannyas. And he has been preaching in India mostly, and also covering countries like Malaysia, Russia, Australia, and Japan. He has been translating the literatures of great Gaudiya Vaishnava Acharyas in the lineage for the past several years. This service has been continuing for several years. Because of his expertise in both Sanskrit and Bengali, he has been able to do this service continuously. Something like 80 wonderful, rare literature have been already translated by him. One of them being Sri Brihad Bhagavatamrita, but so many other wonderful books he has been translating. And so you are all fortunate to be able to have his blessings today. Please listen to him attentively. The darshan of a pure devotee can have a very transforming experience on a person's life. We all long for the meeting with a pure devotee of Krishna, and that opportunity has come to you right now. Please listen to his wonderful words of wisdom, and Krishna will be very pleased with you, because his recommendations from a pure devotee are taken seriously by Lord Krishna. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna. Now you can start hearing Maharaj's lectures.
Oh, Vishnu Badaya Krishna Prasthabhu Dalai Shimadi Bhakti Bhadanda Swami Niki Namane Namaste Saraswata Devi Gauravani Prachalane Nirvishesha Shunyavari Upasana Nirvishesha Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Siyadvaiti Gadada Arshvasati Gauravakti Vrinda Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Rama. In the introduction to the Bhagavad Gita, Srila Prabhupada has explained that the animals have four propensities: eating, sleeping, mating, and defending.
Bhagavad Gita upadghatamulo Srila Prabhupada varu jantuvulaki unde lakshanalni nirvachincharu. Ayana em chepparante aaharam, నిద్రపోవడం, అలాగే మైథునం, అలాగే భయం, ఈ నాలుగు లక్షణాలు జంతువులకు ఉన్నాయని చెప్పారు.
Human being also has the same four activities.
మనుషులు కూడా అదే నాలుగు విధమైన లక్షణాలు, యాక్టివిటీస్ మనుషులు కూడా ఉన్నాయి.
But the human being is not an ordinary animal.
మానవులు అనేది సాధారణ జంతువుల మాదిరి కాదన్నమాట మానవులు.
And he cannot be completely satisfied with these four activities.
మానవులు జంతువులాగే ఈ నాలుగు లక్షణాలు చేస్తూ సంతృప్తి చెందుతూ ఉండలేరు.
So that is why many human beings, they often wonder What am I supposed to do besides these four activities?
So, sadharanamga manavulandaru kuda andarlaage ee vidhanga chestu nene em cheyali ani aalochistu untaru aacharyapothu untaru.
However, they cannot get an answer.
వాళ్ళకి సమాధానం దొరకదు అంత ఈజీగా.
In school they will not get an answer.
స్కూల్లో కూడా మనకి ఈ విషయానికి సమాధానం ఎక్కడ మనకి దొరకదు.
And they cannot get answer from parents or friends.
ఈ ప్రశ్నకి సమాధానం మనకి పెద్దవాళ్ళ దగ్గర నుంచి కానీ స్నేహితుల దగ్గర నుంచి కానీ తల్లిదండ్రుల దగ్గర నుంచి వాళ్ళ దగ్గర నుంచి కూడా మనకి దొరకదు.
So we can speculate on our own. That also is very difficult and there's no conclusion.
మన సొంత కల్పన ద్వారా దీనికి సమాధానం ఏమిటని మనంతటి మనం ఆలోచించినా మనకి ఒక విధమైన కన్ఫ్యూజన్ అనే లభిస్తుంది తప్పించి మనకి నిజమైన సమాధానం మనకి దొరకదు.
The simple way is to go to the scriptures.
అందుకే చాలా ఈజీ సులభమైన విధానం ఏంటంటే శాస్త్రం ద్వారా మన విషయాన్ని తెలుసుకోవడం మంచిది ఎప్పుడు కూడా.
But there are many scriptures in the world. But if one is very fortunate, we will approach the Vedic literature.
చాలా శాస్త్రాలు ఈ ప్రపంచంలో ఉన్నాయి కాబట్టి ఎవరైనా అదృష్టశాలి అదృష్టవంతులు అయితే వేదిక లిటరేచర్ అంటే వేదాల నుంచి ఈ విషయాన్ని తెలుసుకోవడానికి మొదలు పెడతారు.
The Vedas have the most complete knowledge of spiritual law.
వేదములన్నీ కూడా ఆధ్యాత్మిక జ్ఞానం గురించి పూర్తిగా అన్ని విషయాలు కలిగి ఉన్నాయి.
Literature is very vast. There are many works.
Vedallo kuda chala samudram laga chala ekkuva vishayalu vedallo cheppabadi unnai.
There are four Vedas, but there are also Mahabharata, Ramayana and 18 Puranas.
Vedalu nalige adu kaakunda maniki Mahabharatam, Ramayanam, Puranalu kuda chala unnai.
So fortunately everything has been summarized in the Bhagavad.
కానీ అదృష్టసవత్తు మనకి ఏంటంటే భగవద్గీతలో మొత్తం వేదాల సారం మొత్తం అందులో సమకూర్చబడి ఉంది.
What is ever in the Vedas and Upanishads is in the Bhagavad Gita.
వేదాల్లోని ఉపనిషత్తులోని ఏమైతే సారం ఉందో అదంతా కూడా భగవద్గీతలో పూర్తిగా చెప్పబడి ఉంది.
If we study Bhagavad Gita, we have the conclusion of Vedic knowledge.
మనం భగవద్గీత అధ్యయనం చేస్తే మనకి వేదాల యొక్క జ్ఞానం పూర్తిగా మనకి తెలుస్తుంది లభిస్తుంది.
భగవద్గీత has been accepted by all the famous acharyas in India.
భగవద్గీత అందరి చేత కూడా అందరి ఆచార్యుల చేత ఈ ప్రపంచంలో సమ్మతించబడి ఉంది.
Some people will say, oh, why are you only accepting Bhagavad Gita? Bhagavad Gita says Krishna Bhagavan, but I want to worship somebody else. But the acharyas accept Bhagavad Gita as very authoritative.
Kani kontha mandi entante Bhagavad Gita ne enduku chadavali enduku adhyayanam cheyali ani kontha mandi prashnistuntaru kabatte acharyulu gane vaallu Bhagavad Gita ne ok shastranga paraniginchi pramanikanga teeskunnaru.
And even Shankaracharya has written a commentary on Gita.
Even Shankaracharya kuda Bhagavad Gita meeda bhashyam anedi rasaru.
And all the famous Vaishnava acharyas have commentaries on the Bhagavad Gita.
ప్రసిద్ధమైన వైష్ణవాచార్యులు కూడా భగవద్గీత మీద చాలా భాష్యాలు రాశారు.
So the Bhagavad Gita contains the essence of the Vedas.
భగవద్గీత వేదముల యొక్క మొత్తం సారం కూడా భగవద్గీతలో పూర్తిగా వివరించబడి ఉంది.
So though there are 18 chapters, the knowledge of the Bhagavad Gita is very simple.
భగవద్గీతలో 18 అధ్యాయాలు ఉన్నాయి. భగవద్గీత యొక్క జ్ఞానం చాలా సులభమైంది.
We'll find the most important knowledge in the middle six chapters, from chapter 7 through 12.
భగవద్గీతలో మే ముఖ్యముగా 7 నుంచి 12 అధ్యాయాల లోపల భగవద్గీత యొక్క ముఖ్యమైన జ్ఞానం అని చెప్పబడి ఉంది.
And we'll find everything summarized at the end where Krishna says, give up all dharmas and simply surrender unto me.
భగవద్గీత చివర్న శ్రీకృష్ణ భగవానుడు మొత్తం అన్నిటినీ ఒక సారాంశం పూర్తిగా ఏం చెప్పారంటే అందరూ కూడా శ్రీకృష్ణ భగవాన్నే చరణ పొందాలి పూర్తిగా అని శ్రీకృష్ణ భగవానుడు అందరికీ విన్నవించారు.
So in that statement, Krishna indicates that Krishna is supreme.
ఆ వాక్యంలో ఆ శ్లోకంలో మనకి ఏం తెలుస్తుందంటే శ్రీకృష్ణ భగవానుడే దేవాది దేవుడు అని మనకి పూర్తిగా అర్థమవుతుంది.
He says, Mamekam Sharanam Raja, render only to me.
శ్రీ కృష్ణ భగవానుడు ఆ శ్లోకంలో నన్ను మాత్రమే శరణం పొందాలి పొందండి అని చాలా వివరంగా చాలా చెప్పారు.
And he indicates how we should approach him in surrender. That is part of bhakti yoga.
సో అది మనకి ఏ విధమైన ఒక సూచన ఇస్తుందంటే మనం భక్తి యోగాన్ని మనం అనుసరించి మన జీవితంలో అవలంబించి మనం ముందుకు వెళ్ళాలని ఒక విధమైన సూచనని జ్ఞానాన్ని ఇస్తుంది.
సో ద కంక్లూషన్ ఆఫ్ భగవద్ గీత ఇస్ టు పర్ఫార్మ్ భక్తి యోగ అండ్ వర్షిప్.
భగవద్గీత యొక్క సారం ఏంటంటే మనం భక్తి యోగం అనేది జీవితంలో అవలంబించి మనం అనుసరించి మనం జీవితంలో ముందుకు వెళ్ళి సాధించాలి, లక్ష్యం సంపాదించాలని తెలుస్తుంది.
And what is the result?
దానిక ఫలితం ఏమిట మనకి?
Krishna says, I will deliver you from all sins.
శ్రీ కృష్ణ భగవానుడు మనకి ఏం ఉపదేశం చేశారంటే అన్ని పాపాల నుంచి మొత్తం మనల్ని శ్రీకృష్ణ భగవానుడు ముక్తిని పొందిస్తారు.
So sin means suffering.
పాపం అంటే ఏంటంటే మనం బాధల్ని కష్టాలని అనుభవించడం.
Absence of sin means happiness.
పాపం లేదు అంటే సుఖమైన ఆనందంగా జీవితాన్ని గడపడం.
So the result of doing bhakti is that we become completely happy. We get bliss.
భక్తి అనేది మన జీవితంలో అనుసరిస్తే మనం ఆనందంగా సుఖంగా జీవితం మొత్తం మనం ఉంటాం అనే విషయాన్ని మనం అర్థం చేసుకుంటాం.
So happiness is the goal of the individual jiva.
ఆనందం అనేది జీవుల యొక్క అసలైన స్వరూపం, అసలైన లక్షణం.
But that happiness is possibly spiritual happiness.
అందుకే ఆధ్యాత్మిక ఆనందం అనేది చాలా ఉపయోగం.
Our process is to worship Supreme Lord. He is the ultimate spiritual.
అందుకే మనకి చెప్పిన విధానం ఏంటంటే భగవంతుణ్ణి సేవ చేస్తూ మనం ఆనందంగా ఉండడం అనేది జీవితం యొక్క లక్ష్యం, జీవితం యొక్క విధానం.
By this process, we can get complete happiness.
ఈ విధమైన విధానం ద్వారా మనం పూర్తి ఆనందాన్ని జీవితంలో మనం పొందగలం.
And this happiness is beyond the happiness that we get from eating, sleeping, mating, and defending.
మనకు ఈ విధమైన విధానం ద్వారా వచ్చే ఆనందం అనేది మనం మామూలుగా చేసే తినడం, పడుకోవడం, నిద్రించడం అలాగే మిగతా కార్యక్రమాలు జీవితంలో వచ్చే ఆనందం కన్నా ఇది చాలా రెట్లు మెరుగైనది.
So just to get that knowledge, we have to go to the Bhagavad Gita. If we don't go to the Bhagavad Gita, we will not get this knowledge.
ఈ విధమైన జ్ఞానం మనకి కావాలంటే మనం భౌతికీత దగ్గరికే వెళ్ళాలి, భౌతిక నుంచి మనం ఎంత నేర్చుకోవాలి. భౌతికీత నుంచి కాకుండా మిగతా వేటి నుంచి కానీ ఈ జ్ఞానం మనకి లభించదు.
We will not know how to get our happiness.
మీకు తెలియకపోవచ్చు మనం ఈ హ్యాపీనెస్, ఈ ఆనందాన్ని మనం ఏ విధంగా పొందాలని చాలా మందికి తెలియకపోవచ్చు.
So it is important that we get some preliminary knowledge in order to practice.
అందుకే మొదట్లో మనకి ఆరంభంలో మనకి ఆరంభమైన విషయాలు మనం తెలుసుకోవడం అనేది చాలా అవసరం ఆనందం కోసం.
So that knowledge we will get from the Bhagavad Gita.
సో ఆ విధమైన జ్ఞానం అనేది మొదటి నుంచి మనకి ఆరంభం నుంచి భగవద్గీత నుంచే వస్తుంది మనకి.
So by studying Bhagavad Gita, we can understand our nature as Atma, not the body, and we can also understand the nature of the Supreme Lord.
సో భగవద్గీత నుంచి మనం మన యొక్క జీవుల యొక్క స్వరూపం మనకి ఏమిటి, లక్షణం ఏమిటి అనే విషయాన్ని మనం భగవద్గీత నుంచి పూర్తిగా మనం అర్థం చేసుకుంటాం.
And we can understand the activity required in order to realize the Lord, that is yoga.
అందుకే భగవద్గీత నుంచి కూడా మనం ఏమి చేయాలి, మనం ఏ కార్యక్రమాలు మనం చేయాలి ఆ విధమైన ఆనందాన్ని పొందడానికి, ఆ విషయం కూడా మనం భగవద్గీత నుంచి మనం అర్థం చేసుకుంటాం.
Once we have this knowledge, then we should begin this process of worshiping Krishna.
అప్పుడు మనకి ఈ విధమైన జ్ఞానం మనకి వచ్చిన తర్వాత మనం శ్రీకృష్ణ భగవానుడికి సేవ చేస్తూ ఉండడానికి మనం ముందుకు వస్తాం.
So knowledge without action is useless.
జ్ఞానం ఉన్నా సరే అది జీవితంలో అనుసరించి పాటించకపోతే అది పెద్దగా ఉపయోగంగా ఉండదు మనకి.
So we have to practice bhakti yoga.
అందుక మనం భక్తి యోగం అనే విధానాన్ని మనం ముఖ్యంగా పాటించాలి జీవితంలో.
So at the end of the Gita Mahatmya, it is said that what is our action? Our action is service to Krishna.
గీతా మహాత్మ్య చివరిలో కూడా మనం శ్రీకృష్ణ భగవానికి సేవ చేయాలి అనే విషయాన్ని చాలా వివరంగా చెప్పబడింది.
So we can serve Krishna in many ways.
శ్రీకృష్ణ భగవాన్ని మనం చాలా విధములుగా మనం తెలుసుకోగలం.
Even just hearing about Krishna from Bhagavad Gita or Srimad Bhagavatam, that is service.
శ్రీకృష్ణ భగవాన్ గురించి భాగవతం నుంచి కానీ భగవద్గీత నుంచి కానీ మనం వింటే ఆయన గురించి మనం తెలుసుకోవాలి. అది కూడా శ్రీకృష్ణ భగవానికి సేవ చేసినట్టే.
We can worship the deity form.
మనం అచ్చ విగ్రహాలను కూడా మనం అర్చించవచ్చు, సేవ చేయొచ్చు. అది కూడా శ్రీకృష్ణ భగవానికి సేవ.
Or we can visit the temple and offer some flowers.
మనం రాధాకృష్ణ మందిరాలకు వెళ్ళి మనం శ్రీకృష్ణ భగవానికి మనం పువ్వులు పళ్ళు అర్పించిన అది కూడా శ్రీకృష్ణ భగవాన్ సేవ కిందే వస్తుంది.
All of this is part of service or bhakti yoga.
ఇవన్నీ కూడా భక్తి యోగంలో మనం చేసే సేవలు.
But the most powerful way of serving Krishna is nam sankirtan, chanting Krishna's name.
So వీటన్నిటికన్నా చాలా ముఖ్యమైన ప్రసిద్ధమైన శక్తివంతమైన సేవ ఏంటంటే శ్రీకృష్ణ భగవానికి నామం జపించడం.
So at the end of the Gita Mahatmya, it is said that there is one mantra, the name of Krishna.
So శ్రీకృష్ణ గీత మహాత్మ్య యొక్క చివరిలో ఏం చెప్పబడిందంటే ఒకే ఒక మంత్రం అందరూ చేయాలి, అదేంటంటే శ్రీకృష్ణ భగవాన్ యొక్క నామం.
So chanting the name of Krishna is the most powerful way in which we can perform bhakti yoga.
శ్రీకృష్ణ భగవాన్ నామం చెప్పడం అనేది, స్మరించడం జపించడం అనేది చాలా శక్తివంతమైన విధం అని చెప్పబడింది.
It is not secret, everybody can chant it.
ఇది చాలా రహస్యమైన విషయం కాదు, అందరూ దీన్ని చేయగలరు, చేయొచ్చు కూడా.
యంగ్ పీపుల్ కెన్ చాంట్, ఓల్డ్ పీపుల్ కెన్ చాంట్.
యవనంలో ఉన్న వాళ్ళు చేయగలరు, అలాగే ఇంకెవరైనా చేయగలరు, అందరూ చేయగలరు.
మ్యారీడ్ పీపుల్ కెన్ చాంట్, అన్మ్యారీడ్ పీపుల్.
కళ్యాణం అయిన వాళ్ళు చేయగలరు, వివాహం చేసుకోని వాళ్ళు కూడా చేయగలరు.
మెన్ కెన్ చాంట్, విమెన్ కెన్ చాంట్.
మనం స్త్రీలు చేయగలరు, అందరూ చేయగలరు.
People from all countries of the world can chant.
ప్రపంచంలో అన్ని దేశాల్లో ఉన్న అన్ని అందరు ప్రజలు కూడా ఈ నామాన్ని చేయగలరు.
But it is still the most powerful means of attaining Krishna.
అయినా సరే ఇది చాలా శక్తివంతమైన విధానం శ్రీకృష్ణ భగవాన్ని పొందడానికి.
So along with your study and getting knowledge of Krishna and bhakti yoga, you should always chant Krishna's name.
Mano bhakti yogalo mano ee vishayalta adhyanam chestuntamo adhyanam chestundanto paatu ee naamanni kuda mano eppudu japistu undadam anedi chaala avasaram.
Yeah, by following this process you can attain this goal of complete eternal happiness.
ఈ విధంగా విధానాన్ని మనం జీవితంలో అనుసరిస్తే మనం పూర్తిగా ఆనందాన్ని, మన జీవిత యొక్క లక్ష్యాన్ని మనం సాధించగలం.
In this way we fulfill the goal of human life.
ఈ విధంగా మనం జీవిత యొక్క అసలైన లక్ష్యం అనేది మనం పొందగలం, సాధించగలం.
So by practicing the instructions of Bhagavad Gita, we can actually become much, much superior to animals. An animal life.
So mano ee vidhanga bhagavadgita upadeshalanu mano jeevithallo paatinchadam valla jantuvula yokka asalaina vidhanam lakshanalu nunchi mano manavula yokka lakshanaloku mano raagalam.
And we can attain eternal happiness.
Mano mana jeevithallo shashvatamaina aanandanni pondadaniki mano margam manaki labhistundi.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. You must all be feeling quite blessed by a wonderful address from His Holiness Bhanuswami Maharaj, a personal disciple of Srila Prabhupada, a very senior guru sannyasi from the ISKCON family. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, sadhu sanga sadhu sanga sadhu sanga koya lava matra sadhu sanga sarva siddhi haya. This is a Bengali couplet. The meaning is to obtain the association of a pure devotee, sadhu, is so very rare. It is so very special. And what is the effect of such association with a pure devotee of Krishna who is coming down in the parampara system? Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, lava matra sadhu sangha. Lava means a very small measure of time. You know, it is like a second or a nanosecond. Even that short association of a pure devotee has a transforming power. Sarvasiddhihaya. That means it makes your life perfect. It puts you on the path towards perfection. You just have to go following that path, and the Guru's blessings will guide you along the path. So that great blessing you have all received by listening to His Holiness Vanaswami Maharaj. Now it is my pleasant duty to take you on a conducted tour of our ISKCON Chennai temple. So I welcome you all warmly to Chennai, and from wherever you are, I am going to transport you to Chennai temple by a special facility which is completely spiritual in nature. Let us all chant the Maha Mantra 3 times, and lo and behold, we'll be in Chennai temple. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna. Now we have arrived at ISKCON Chennai temple, in a place about 20-25 kilometers on the outskirts of Chennai city, in a very scenic place, very close to the beach, in a place called Akkarai, on the road leading to Mahabalipuram from Chennai. So now we are entering the temple from the left, and you can see the main entrance of the temple. This beautiful temple at multi-levels was designed by His Holiness Vanaswami Maharaj, who is also an expert astrologer and astronomer as well. So with his great knowledge of the scriptures, this temple has been designed. It has got very, very wonderful features. So now you are seeing a side view of the temple. Now we will show you more views. Now you are seeing the temple again from the front, from the parking area. So you park your vehicle here and you move ahead, and you reach the temple entrance. So this is a evening view of the temple. This is the temple beautifully lit up. You know, the lights are all hidden. The light source is hidden, but the light produces such magical effects on the temple facade. You can see the chakra on top of the temple. There are 3 kalashas on top, which indicates there are 3 altars inside. And there is a chakra on top of each of them. The chakra is a representation of the Lord inside. So even as you reach the temple, you take the darshan of the chakra and you offer your obeisances to the lordships inside. Now we move up the flight of staircases. I will show you a few more darshans of the temple frontage. So you can see a flight of stairs leading up. Then once you go up, there is a staircase from both sides which can take you further up the temple. So let us move up now. Here is the picture from the inauguration of the temple, which was about 6-7 years from today. There is a helicopter showering flower petals on the participants, the devotees who all assembled for the temple inauguration. Actually, originally ISKCON temple was functioning from very humble premises in the city in 2-3 places, but then a land was acquired, as it was wished by Srila Prabhupada, that there should be a grand majestic temple in Chennai which should attract people in hundreds of thousands to enter into Krishna consciousness. So this dream of Srila Prabhupada came to fruition about 6-7 years ago, and this is a picture from the inauguration of the temple. And here now we have entered. I showed you the staircase, we have gone up, and we are now standing in front of the altar of none other than Srila Prabhupada, the man who at the age of 70, with no money on his hands, left India. He had no followers, he had no backers either from India or from America. He had no passage to pay even for the journey, so he went by a cargo ship, a freeboarder on a cargo ship. He suffered multiple heart attacks on the sea, and after 38 days of journey, he reached America. Again, remember, he had no money with him. He did not even know where he was going, but he was very clear. There were two things with him. One was his Guru Maharaj, Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur, was with him in the form of his instruction. The instruction was, you should go to the Western world and preach in English. His second instruction was, with whatever money you have, you print books and distribute them to the people to make them devotees. So these two instructions were going with Srila Prabhupada. So for preaching, he was going personally. And as far as books were concerned, he had already printed the first canto of Srimad Bhagavatam from India with the help of donations received from well-wishers. Those books, he was carrying them with him in the same ship. So Srila Prabhupada and his books, some 200 volumes of the first canto of Srimad Bhagavatam, and a trunk, a steel trunk that contained his personal effects of maybe a couple of dhotis and kurtas, and maybe a bag of potatoes and atta, nothing more than that. With this, he went on a journey from India to America with a mission of setting up Krishna consciousness throughout the world. So he was accompanied by his guru in the form of his instructions, and Krishna in the form of his books. So let us take darshan of Srila Prabhupada. And Prabhupada is sitting right opposite to the altar. Okay, so you can imagine, when you are looking at Prabhupada, the altar is behind you. Prabhupada is constantly taking darshan of the deities. This is how most of these ISKCON temples are arranged. Wherever the space permits, Srila Prabhupada is sitting right opposite to the altar, facing the deities. This is the temple hall. Now Srila Prabhupada is behind you, and in front of you is the altar. You can see three clear altars. I showed you three kalashams on top of the temple. They represent these three altars. On the left, we have Gauranithai. I will show you close-up shots presently. On the left, you have Gauranithai, that is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Nityananda Prabhu, whose names we are chanting daily whenever there is class or whenever we are chanting the Mahamantra. Before that, we are chanting their names. And in the middle altar, we have Krishna and Radha Rani. So that is Radha Krishna in the center, and they are flanked by Lalita and Vishakha Sakhi. They are two intimate Sakhis of this couple. Lalita Sakhi is standing by the side of Krishna and Vishakha Sakhi by the side of Radha Rani. So this is the middle altar, and on the right you have Jagannath, Baladev, Subhadra Maharani and Sudarshan. So Jagannath is Lord Krishna, Baladev of course is Balaram. In the middle we have Subhadra Devi, she is none other than the Yogamaya potency of the Lord, and then Sudarshan. So this is the main altar. Now we will take you to closer darshans of each of these deities. Now we have come straight to Radha Krishna in the center. Yeah, you take this beautiful darshan. The deities are named as Radha Krishna. In most of the other temples they have they are either called Radha Govinda, Radha Madan Mohan, Radha Gopinath, Radha Damodar. Each temple, they have their own names. In London, they are called Radha Londoneshwara, the ISKCON temple in London. The ISKCON temple in Paris is called Radha Parishishwara. So that way he is Radha Chennai Ishwara, but his name is Radha Krishna. You can see their beautiful smile. Krishna standing without any worries, in a threefold bending form, with a very pleasant smile on his face, with a flute in his hand, with a nice turban on his head, decorated with beautiful peacock feathers. His black cascading curly hair is decorating his back, it is circling his head. And there is this beautiful garland of flowers on his neck, and his body fully decorated with nice dresses and ornaments, rings, armlets, and on the anklets, and so many other ornaments on his body, necklaces, that beautiful. And then by the side of Krishna stands Radharani. By now you all know that Radharani is an expansion of Krishna, right? In the beginning it was Krishna alone, but when Krishna wanted to expand his joy, then he expanded himself, and his internal pleasure potency became Radharani. So she is the Shakti of Krishna. Krishna is Shaktiman, and Radharani is his Shakti. All other Shaktis proceed from Radharani. So that way, in Vaikuntha, you have Vishnu and Lakshmi. That Lakshmi is an expansion of Radharani. Same way, all the gopis in the Goloka, they are all expansions of Radharani. That way, she is the pleasure potency. She is constantly meditating, how I can give pleasure to Krishna. And she knows exactly what is in Krishna's mind. And she knows exactly how to fulfill that desire. So she is the Lokamata. She is Jagajanani. She is all our mother. And she is Madana Mohana Mohini. Krishna can make the Cupid, the Lord of Love, faint by his beauty. And Radharani can make that Madana Mohan to faint. So she is called Madana Mohana Mohini. Krishna is constantly hankering for the association of Radharani, and vice versa. So this is the beautiful darshan of this couple. And now you see, they are flanked by, you see on the left hand side, our left, that is Lalita Sakhi. She is slightly older to Radharani. And Vishakha Sakhi, she is slightly younger to Radharani. They have actually 8 intimate Sakhis. Radha and Krishna, they have 8 intimate Sakhis. They are all assistants of Radharani. And what do? They always try to bring Krishna and Radha together. They are constantly meditating on how to bring them both together and have nice pastimes. They just want to make them happy. For this purpose, they are constantly making plans. And they are assisted by unlimited number of gopis in Goloka. So this is a scene from Goloka, what we are seeing. Radha and Krishna and Lalita and Vishakha on either side. Lalita is holding probably a plate of pan to offer to the couple, and Vishakha is holding a whisk with which he is fanning them. So this is the beautiful scene from Goloka. They are always enjoying. There is no worry. That's why the entire spiritual world is called Vaikuntha, and this is a scene from Vaikuntha. They are all enjoying happily. So this is a different day's darshan. Every day the Lord enjoys different dresses, different sets of ornaments. Temple has got hundreds of such wonderful ornaments gifted by various devotees, or the temple also on special occasions buys them by placing special orders with special tailors. And they are designed by devotees, and they are made and offered to the Lord on various special days like Janmashtami, Radhashtami, Gopashtami, Mahaprabhu's appearance day, Gaurapurnima, or Ram Navami. Like that, the year is filled with so many wonderful days. On each of these days, they wear new dresses. So this is another darshan. You can take the lotus feet darshan of Krishna. And you cannot take the darshan of Radharani's lotus feet, which are very special. You can see her dress is always covering her lotus feet. But in our mind, we can catch hold of her lotus feet and beg her, oh Radharani, the way you are so dear to Krishna, please connect me with Krishna. And please engage me in Krishna's service. You are constantly engaged in his service. Please also engage me in the service of the divine couple. You can also pray to Lalita Sakhi and Vishakha Sakhi to take us as their assistants in the various pastimes of Goloka. You know Goloka is an eternal place, It is always present tense there. There is no past tense, future tense. It is always present tense. So it is always new, always fresh, always increasing happiness. People don't get old. People don't become sick or die. Yeah, nobody ages beyond 16 years. The entire place is so young. And also the trees in Goloka, there are Kalpavriksha trees. And the sand dust is called Chintamani. And the cows are called Surabhi and Kamadenu, which means everything around you has the ability to fulfill all your desires. But what kind of desires we are likely to have in Goloka? Our only desire is to be in the association of Radha Krishna and their devotees and to engage in various services for them. As we do services, we become filled with joy. Say, for example, there are a couple of gopas who are constantly fanning Krishna. Like one person is called Raktaka. He is fanning Krishna. And while he is fanning Krishna, just by looking at the beauty of Krishna, his mind is overwhelmed, you know, and his senses become stunned. His eyes are covered in tears of love. His body is just shaking and trembling in great joy and love. And then he is cursing himself. Why this ecstasy is coming to me? You know, in this world, we are all praying, when I will feel this ecstasy of association with Krishna and Radharani and the gopis. But there, he is cursing himself because it is interfering with his service to Krishna. He is getting the greatest happiness by serving Krishna. So he says, anything else is an interference. So in this picture, you see more participants. Who are they? The cow and the calf. They are everywhere in Goloka. The place is called Goloka. You see, the highest planet in the spiritual world is Goloka. Now you understand how cows are important for us. Cows give us milk. They have the magical power to transform useless things into such wonderful food for the whole humanity. We are putting dried up oil cakes and straw and grass, which none of us can eat. They eat them and they give us such miracle food called milk. I have already explained in our classes how this milk can generate special fine tissues in the brain with which you can progress spiritually. Otherwise, spirituality is beyond our understanding. We are all materialistic people. How we will understand spirituality? So that is the great help that cow's milk, butter, ghee, dahi, they are all giving us that special spiritual tissues in the brain. And you can see the Urchava Vigrahas in front of you. One is Radha, Krishna flanked by Rukmini and Satyabhama. That is on the left hand side. In the center you have Govardhan Shila, which is a stone from Govardhan Hill. The entire Govardhan Hill is Krishna, and every stone from Govardhan Hill also represents Krishna. And the other stone is the Shaligram Shila. They are both decorated like the face of the Krishna. You can see his eyes and the smiling mouth, you can see. So this is the center altar. And this is one more darshan. Look at the beautiful dresses that the deities are wearing. So like this, some more close-up shots of Radha and Krishna. They are eternally smiling, eternally dancing, and eternally having songs, either vocal or with this flute. Songs and dancing and prancing is constantly going on. This is the scene of Goloka. So we have seen so many beautiful darshans of Radha and Krishna. Let us pray for their blessings. And our only prayer is, please take us to be with you to Goloka. We will never dream of coming back to this material world. This material world was simply a nightmare for us. By mistake, we spirit souls who are your eternal associates, by mistake we have come to this world. We no longer want to stay here. Please take us back with you. This is our prayer. So we have enjoyed such wonderful darshans of Radha and Krishna. This is a close-up of Krishna. What a wonderful, his eyes are described like lotus petals, you know, running from ear, touching both the ears, the left eye and the right eye, they are touching the ears. And his beautiful nose and his wonderful reddish lip and the flute, which is constantly in association with his just wonderful lip. The nectar from his lips are constantly enjoyed by the flute, and the black hair surrounding his head, and the wonderful tilaka on his forehead, and the beautiful eyebrows. If anybody is troubled by lust, they are advised to meditate on the beautiful bow-like eyebrows of Krishna. Then lust will simply run away from you. And this is another beautiful darshan of Krishna. So now we come to the darshan of Jagannath Baladev Subhadra. You know they are the main deities of Jagannath Puri. So they actually represent Krishna Balaram and the Yogamaya potency. The main deities are at the back. The Utsava deities are in the front. You can see them. On the right hand side, you can also see Lakshmi Narasimha Dev Utsava deities. So this is the darshan of Jagannath Baladev Subhadra. Actually, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu spent the second half of his life. He took sannyas at the age of 24. He walked on this planet for only 48 years. Then he returned to Goloka. So during the second 24 years as a sannyasi, he stayed entirely in Jagannath Puri. Every day he would go and take darshan of Jagannath. Actually, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is who? He is Krishna himself. But one difference, here you see Jagannath is black, but Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is golden color. Why he is golden color? Because he is Krishna, but in the mood of Radharani. He is not thinking of himself as Krishna. He is thinking of himself as Radharani. So whenever he sees Krishna, he is pulled by love. Same way when Jagannath sees Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he sees Radharani in him. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu sees Krishna in Jagannath. So they have very many wonderful pastimes. And Baladev came in Chaitanya Leela as Nityananda Prabhu. I will show you their darshans very shortly. So you can see Baladev is holding the mace and the hull, the plow with him. They are his weapons. And Jagannath is holding the shankha and chakra. And there is also the chakra by the side. So this is darshan of Jagannath Baladev Subhadra Maharani Ki Jai. So this is their wonderful darshan. See these beautiful garments they are wearing, wonderful backdrops, nice flower crowns that they are wearing, and the beautiful smile on their face. And they are constantly welcoming devotees. Please come, please come. I will take you back to Goloka. Please give up all these nonsensical engagements of this material world. Just surrender to me. I will take you back to Goloka. So this is the promise they are giving. So with these beautiful darshans of Jagannath, Baladev and Subhadra, we shall now move on to Gauranithai. We call them Gauranithai. On your right hand side is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He is called Gaura. And on your left hand side is Nityananda Prabhu. He is called Nithai. So the right hand side, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is actually Krishna. And Nityananda Prabhu is Balaram. They both appeared in the 15th century, later part of 15th century, 500 plus years ago from now. And both of them were in golden color. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is golden because he is in the mood of Radharani. Radharani has a golden form, so Chaitanya also has a golden form. He is called Gauranga. 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 Gauranga means one whose limbs are golden in complexion. So they used to say, the poets used to call both of them as golden mountains, you know. They were extraordinarily tall, like 7 feet, like that. And they were so beautiful. Their limbs were so perfectly formed. They were like replica of Krishna and Balaram. Only difference is Gauranga, he is golden colored. Krishna Varnam, Tvisha Akrishna, which means he was constantly chanting the name of Krishna. And he was Krishna himself, but his color was not Krishna. Krishna means black. One meaning of Krishna is black. So he was not black in color. He was golden color. And what were they doing when they appeared in the 15th century? They were distributing Krishna Prema, which is the greatest blessing that we can ask for. Now you have all learnt Bhagavad Gita. Bhagavad Gita is practically teaching you to perform Krishna Bhakti, to go back to Krishna. Bhagavad Gita throughout it says Bhakta is the greatest yogi, and until you get pure love for me, you follow your spiritual master and follow the instructions of your spiritual master. By doing it regularly, you will attain spontaneous love for Krishna. And then you will come back to me. This is what Krishna told us in Bhagavad Gita 5000 years ago. The same Krishna appeared 500 years ago. This was also predicted in scriptures. Maybe in future classes, I will share with you. Even in Vishnu Sahasranamam, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's arrival is predicted. And in so many scriptures like Padma Puranam and so many other Puranams, and in Upanishads, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's arrival has been predicted. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, who is Krishna himself, taught us how to surrender to Krishna. And he was freely distributing Krishna Prema, which is so difficult to obtain. Anyone who has obtained Krishna Prema will go back to Krishna. There is absolutely no obstacle that can hold him back in this material world. Anyone who is a lover of Krishna, anyone who is a Krishna Premi, he will go back to Krishna. Nothing can stop him. That Krishna Prema, which is so very difficult to obtain in this material world, either by tapasya or by yajna or by dana, by doing ashtanga yoga, jnana yoga, nishkama karma yoga, by doing any of these things, we cannot get Krishna Prema. The only way to get Krishna Prema is through another devotee. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came as a devotee. Krishna himself came as a devotee and he distributed Krishna Prema to everybody. Of course, he also had his guru, because he is showing by example how we can attain Krishna. So he is coming in the parampara of Brahma Madhva Gaudiya Sampradaya. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's guru's name was Ishwarapuri. We will learn all these things in future classes. So let us take this wonderful darshan of Gauranithai. What were they doing? They were constantly chanting the holy name, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Like that, they were constantly singing, constantly dancing, constantly crying in separation from Krishna and Radharani, and they were going everywhere and inducing people to chant the holy name. Because only by chanting the holy name, we can get the pure love of Krishna. And because this holy name has been given personally by Krishna himself, appearing as Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, this mantra has got extra potency. So for this Kali Yuga, this is the prescribed mantra for deliverance. This mantra calls upon Krishna, Rama, Hari. All these are names of Krishna, and especially the word Hare represents Radharani also. So Radharani is, you know, the internal pleasure potency, the love potency of Krishna. So when you call upon these three names in the mood of a crying child, then the mantra will connect you with Krishna. Actually, the mantra is non-different from Krishna. By regularly chanting this mantra with feeling, you will get pure Krishna Prem and you will go back to Krishna. This is the promise of Krishna. This is the promise of Parampara. This is the promise of the scriptures. So now we know what is the perfection of our life. Perfection of our life is to chant the holy names and go back to Krishna. So look at this beautiful dress. And they are dancing, you see. They were constantly singing. They were constantly dancing. And they were also constantly inducing others to sing and dance. The dancing of Mahaprabhu, Nityananda Prabhu are so famous. They were born in West Bengal, in Nadia district, in a place called Mayapur. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was born there. Nityananda Prabhu was born to his parents in a place called Ekachakra, which is about 5-6 hours journey from Mayapur. So by Krishna's plan, he took birth as Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Nityananda Prabhu. He also brought his parents from Goloka to take birth in the material world. And this is how the whole Leela took place. All the associates of Krishna also took place in Chaitanya Leela. Krishna Varnam, Tusha Krishnam, Sangopanga Astra Parshadam, Yajnair Sankirtana Praye, Yajanti Sumedha Saha. Srimad Bhagavatam says, Krishna will come. See, Bhagavatam is 5000 years old, but the Bhagavatam is telling, Krishna will come in the form of, in golden complexion. And he will be accompanied by his weapons, his associates, and his intimate servants. So all of them came with him. And they had wonderful, wonderful pastimes in both in West Bengal for the first 24 years when Mahaprabhu was a teacher of grammar, and then he became a devotee also, and then he took sannyas and he came to Jagannath Puri. So everywhere wonderful leelas were performed. All these stories are contained in a book called Chaitanya Charitamrita and Chaitanya Bhagavata. Going forward in future classes, we will be discussing all these subjects. You will be drowned in love and joy and ecstasy, I can promise you that. Srimad Bhagavatam itself is a much, much sweeter literature as even compared to Bhagavad Gita. Because you see, Bhagavad Gita is spoken to fallen souls like us. So we cannot understand higher subjects. So Krishna is only inducing us. Come on, you are not this body, you are a spirit soul. Try to understand me and come to me. That is the simple message of Bhagavad Gita. To teach us that we are not material bodies. Material body is a miserable thing and material world is a miserable place. So he is telling us, give up this material consciousness. Develop your spiritual consciousness by meditating upon me, by surrendering to me. In Bhagavatam, you understand Krishna more intimately. But in Chaitanya Charitamrita, you are practically touching him shoulder to shoulder. You will get such an intimate picture of the Supreme Lord. What he is thinking, what he is feeling, what he is speaking, what he is doing, like that. And also you will get an intimate view of his close associates and devotees. So that is the excellent blessing you will get in future classes. So with this, look at this, in a beautiful full moon night, Gauranita is dancing. These are typically the dress, you know, they wear during the night, just before the night darshan. This is called night darshan. After this, the temple will close. So the deities, with this dress, you can take darshan in the morning also. Morning 4:30, there is a Mangala Arati darshan, and this will be the darshan at that time. Same thing, closing time. And at 7 o'clock, they wear gorgeous dresses. You have seen the other dresses, the gorgeous dresses. These are the dresses they wear at 7 o'clock in the morning. So you see, they are constantly changing dresses. What they are wearing today, tomorrow they will not be wearing. What they are wearing in the morning, they are not wearing in the afternoon. And what is in the afternoon, they are not wearing in the evening, changing. So like that, there are devotees. Basically, all ISKCON devotees are volunteers. Most of them are grihasthas and some of them are brahmachari. They are happily serving the Lord, no remuneration. Remuneration is the joy that the Lord floods your heart with. What is money? What money can do? Money can give you anxiety, worry, greed and jealousy. But love can fill your heart. See, until the soul is satisfied, we cannot experience happiness. Actually, we are souls, but we are misidentifying with our body and mind. And that is why we are suffering in this world. By correctly associating ourselves with the Supreme Lord as His servant, all our miseries will disappear. So all the people who serve in the temple, they are all completely volunteers. They don't get paid. And they get paid by Krishna directly, by flooding their heart with Krishna Prema. And the temple hall I showed you, in the temple, there are constantly classes going on. And in these classes, Bhagavatam is discussed, Bhagavad Gita is discussed. Regular visitors to the temple will sit for these classes. Also, senior devotees, they come regularly. The temple brahmacharis, they come regularly. So, ISKCON temple is not just a temple. It's not a mere temple. It is a university of Vedic knowledge. Where do you have such a university in this world? In the secular country, you can turn nowhere to get a good teaching of the scriptures. People have their own agendas. But here is a place where the only aim of ISKCON is to make more devotees. We want to make more devotees. If I see somebody progressing faster than me, I become happy. This is what Chaitanya Mahaprabhu taught. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, you let others go ahead of you in Krishna Prema, in Krishna Bhakti, and you be the last. And this is the lower floor. Temple is on the upper floor. This is the lower floor. In this place, they have various functions. The temple organizes various functions for children, for grown-ups, etc. on various occasions. We have in the basement, there is a prasadam area where 500,000 people can be served on special occasions. 4,000, 5,000 people assembled there for participating in the functions and all. So with this, we come to the end of this presentation. Thank you very much. I extend a warm welcome to all of you to visit Chennai and visit the temple. Whenever your time permits, whenever the COVID relaxes, now the temple is already open. from the first of this month, darshans are started, but the regular pujas and all have not started for reasons you all know. But we all hope that everything will be open soon. There is a beautiful restaurant called Higher Taste. It's a Govinda's restaurant where you can get excellent prasadam. There is a gift shop where you can buy various mementos, and you can also have, if you visit on Sundays, nice prasadam in the temple, which is absolutely free. Also during the day, the temple distributes prasadam in drones, you know, throughout the day. So it is my great pleasure to take you around this temple. Whenever you do come, please let me know. Our devotees will be very happy to take you around. The temple president's name is His Grace Sumitra Krishna Prabhu and his good wife Tharani Mataji. They will be very happy to help you have a wonderful darshan. So with this, we conclude our tour. You can access the temple through the website. You can go to ISKCON Chennai website and you can have more darshans where you want. You can also make donations to the temple. Whatever amount you feel like doing, you can always donate. And the temple also has bookshops where you can buy various books of Srila Prabhupada and other disciples of Srila Prabhupada. So it is practically like a college or a university, you can say. So anyone who visits the temple once will definitely come again and again because of the ambience. And His Holiness Bhanuswami Maharaj is the person whose vision is behind the design and construction of this temple. There are so many other features with this temple that it has been built on the Vastu principles. It has got various chakras and the benefits of chakras. Everything is inscribed on the walls of the temple. So it will be an excellent visit for all of you. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna. And here is an important announcement for all of you. You have all been asking what we are going to be doing next. So this is an announcement for the immediate future, for the coming month, starting from coming Saturday. So I will read out for you. The most auspicious Damodar month starts from next Saturday, 31st October. So the coming Saturday is the auspicious commencement of Damodar month. Our spiritual benefits are multiplied thousandfold, just like Purushottam month. During this month, which is most dear to Krishna, Purushottam month, you know, comes once in 3 years, but this Damodar month comes every year. This month, whatever spiritual activity you do, the benefits are multiplied 1,000 times. We have planned wonderful spiritual engagements for all of you for the whole month. So we are going to make these announcements in all the groups, WhatsApp and Telegram groups. So please watch the group. Our announcements will appear in the next few days in this group. But in any case, our Saturday, our once in a week engagements will continue going forward. And what we are going to do next, we shall be announcing. But for the immediately commencing Damodar month, we have planned so many engagements for you so that your spiritual credits will be multiplied 1,000 times during this period. Thank you very much. Please stay tuned and connected to us. Let us enjoy this wonderful spiritual journey, which is nothing like a material journey where you don't know where you are going. In this journey, we all know we are going to back home, back to Krishna. Hare Krishna.